I'm going to do a real quick tutorial using fraps again. As you can see, I got in the movies folder another folder called new folder, and here we see off the C drive movies new folder. This is the video right now that I'm doing. This is the icon for it as it's capturing right now. As you can see on the screen, you can actually hide your mouse cursor, you can actually record the Vista sound, you can record external inputs. And if you want, you can get a little bit better quality, I guess, out of the Fraps recording software. I've actually never had to use this setting. They come out really good, the tutorials I've been doing with the Fraps software so far. Like I said before in the other video, you have to have it monitor the Arrow desktop to record the whole desktop. But I'm going to minimize this, and you can see in here we have a MPEGs folder, and we also have one called Canon. And what I'm going to do with these video clips in the Canon folders, try and bring them into Premiere. Let me minimize these real quick. And here's just a folder within Premiere called Canon Camera. Now if I navigate to the Canon folder in here and I try and import these, Premiere will not do it. See, it couldn't do it because of the MOD, the file extension. But if we just call up the MPEGs folder, and this one as well, all I need to do is actually copy and paste these. Well, I actually don't need to. I could actually just, well, I'll actually copy and paste it just for the purposes of this. I could actually just change the file extension of these right here, and that's usually what you would do. But for the purpose of these videos, for this tutorial, I'm going to actually rename this. I'm just going to put the MPEG file extension on it real quick. And yes, we want to save it. And same with this one here. I want to rename this one. And I'm just going to put MPEG on it. And these were, like I said, in the Canon folder. These are in the one called MPEGs. Now if I minimize these again and I go for the ones in the MPEG folder, we're still in the Canon folder right now. But if I actually come into my computer, and you're going to see me go to the MPEGs folder, which is right here. Here's the two ones right here. I kept the new folder in there so you'd know that this is definitely the same folder that it was. And when I import them now, they will import without any problems, because most of those cameras that you buy at Best Buy or even at ABC Warehouse actually are using an MPEG derivative to actually capture, you know, the video, I guess. Whether you could say it's an alternative to MPEG, really. Most of them are using probably like an MPEG 4 derivative. But here they are coming in right now. There wasn't any transcoding again with these. And what you're seeing here is a 3:4 aspect ratio, and this isn't actually taking up the full screen. Sometimes you want it to, sometimes you don't. But as far as the 3:4 as opposed to the 4:3 as opposed to 16:9, we can correct that real quick by going into interpret footage, and then we're going to go conform to a widescreen. Now, as you can tell, it doesn't take up the full screen because this is an HD project and this is SD footage, but you can go scale the frame size and it takes care of that. Well, there you go, folks. I imported it into the Premiere Pro timeline and I didn't have to do any transcoding. There was software that came with my Canon camera, and I don't doubt that if I installed the software on my computer, that once that codec was on there, Premiere would just bring it in without a hitch. But I really didn't want to install that software, you know, that came with the camera on my system. I just don't need to use it. I'm sure it's something that's probably similar to Windows Movie Maker. So, you know, that's one way to get around it. I mean, Premiere's pretty good at taking in any video codec that is actually on your computer system. So I hope you guys kind of enjoyed this video. I know some people have had problems bringing in, you know, footage from their camera into Premiere. Premiere will do it. It's just the file extension that's stopping it from coming in. So Well, that is pretty much the end of this video tutorial. I hope you folks have learned something, and thanks for watching. Hopefully you'll check out some of my other videos.